Hello students, good afternoon. Today I will start a topic for semester 4 physics honors CBCS course, and the core course is C9. In this course I will start the first topic of C9, and that is quantum theory of light. In this chapter, we will discuss about wave particle duality and photoelectric effect. As you know that the phenomenon of interference, diffraction and polarization of light can only be explained by considering that light travels in the form of wave, or it is an electromagnetic radiation. Frank Hertz experiment showed that the energy of an electromagnetic wave is absorbed or emitted in discrete quanta or photons which move with velocity of light. The photoelectric effect gives the evidence that the photons behave like particles, that is, the electromagnetic radiation or light is corpuscular in nature. Now come to the wave particle duality, that a wave behave as particle and also a particle behave as wave. Wave as particle, the experimental evidence of corpuscular nature of electromagnetic radiation is, the first evidence is photoelectric effect, in which experimentally it has been proved that electromagnetic wave behave as particle, and particle behave as wave was discussed in another chapter, that is de Broglie waves. So come to the photoelectric effect. Let us, the photoelectric effect give evidence that photons behave like particles, that is, electromagnetic radiation or light is corpuscular in nature. So first explain the what is photoelectric effect. As you know, when electromagnetic waves of particular frequency and wavelength incident on certain metal surface, then electrons are emitted from the metal surface. This phenomenon is called photoelectric effect. There are certain basic features of the photoelectric effect. Number one, a minimum frequency of electromagnetic wave is required for the ejection of electron from the metal surface, called threshold frequency, denoted by nu naught. And is characteristic of the emitting surface. Number two, the velocity of ejected electron, the velocity of ejected electrons depend upon frequency of the incident light and independent of its intensity. Number three, third point is the number of electrons emitted from the metal surface depend upon intensity of incident wave and independent of frequency of the incident wave. The nature of photoelectric effect could not be explained by classical theory of light. It was explained by Einstein in 1905 on basis of quantum theory of Planck. Now, what is quantum theory of Planck? According to Planck's theory, electromagnetic radiation does not act like a wave only, but consists of quanta or photons of energy h nu, where h is Planck's constant and nu is frequency of incident wave. Let nu equal to frequency of incident wave, nu naught is threshold frequency, nu must be greater than nu naught. m is mass of ejected electron. What is m? M is mass of ejected electron. Let v is velocity of ejected electrons. Then according to law of conservation of energy, h nu, this is our total energy, this is equal to h nu naught plus half mv square, or half mv square is equal to h nu minus nu naught. This equation is called Einstein's photoelectric equation. Now, this equation agrees with experimental observations since it clearly shows